Welcome to the Fragrance Foundation 2021 Awards. Thank you to our sponsors, Platinum, Estee Lauder Companies, Firmenich, Givaudan, Hearst, Interparfum, Gold, Byredo, Chanel, Coty, Diptyque, IFF, L'Oreal, LVMH, Puig, Sephora, Shiseido, Takasago, Victoria's Secret, Silver, Arcade Beauty, Cosmo International Fragrances, Macy's, Mann, Nest New York, Nordstrom, Revlon, Roberté, The Fragrance Group, Ulta.
Welcome to all of you in our global community. We will now kick off the show with a very special conversation between Oprah Winfrey and our Fragrance Foundation artistic collaborator, Louis Schwartzberg.
With a career spanning more than three decades, acclaimed photographer and filmmaker Louis Schwartzberg has turned his passion for capturing nature's beauty into his life's work. An award-winning cinematographer, he is a master of the art of time-lapse photography. It was when he was a student at UCLA that Louis discovered his gift for visual storytelling. Finding his voice through his innovative approaches to photographing nature. Over the years, he accumulated a library of breathtaking footage that first caught the attention of advertisers, and eventually other TV and film producers took note, wanting to use Louis's awe-inspiring shots in their projects.
Roll camera.
Today, Louis remains as dedicated as ever, capturing nature's beauty to touch people's hearts.
That's pretty cool.
His feature films, including the 3D IMAX Mysteries of the Unseen World, spotlight the wonders of life we tend to overlook or take for granted. Lately, Louis's been zooming in on these little guys who inspired his TED Talk on the beauty of pollination. By capturing and sharing the everyday miracles that our eyes may otherwise never witness, Louis Schwartzberg hopes we will experience a deeper spiritual connection to the world around us. And nowhere is that more apparent than in his short film called Gratitude.
You think this is just another day in your life? It's not just another day. It's a gift. It's the only gift that you have right now. And the only appropriate response is gratefulness.
It is a celebration of the gift of life and a call to open our hearts to the everyday wonders that surround us. It serves as a beautiful reminder of what many of us already know, that gratitude has the power to transform lives.
Let the gratefulness overflow into blessing all around you. Then it will really be a good day.
He is prolific, never without a camera. Louis has been filming nonstop for the past three decades, creating some of the world's most spectacular time-lapse photography.
We're hardwired to protect what we love, and I want people to fall in love with nature in order to protect it.
Do you consider your films to be a visual meditation?
It is a visual meditation. I think it's actually visual healing. You don't have to think about it intellectually. You just have to, I think, let go and feel it emotionally.
feel a little emotional looking at that. This footage was edited specially for Ted by Ted's very own purveyor of natural wonder, Louis Schwartzberg.
Welcome to the 2021 Fragrance Foundation Awards. I am Linda Levy, the president of the Fragrance Foundation. I thank the thousands of you who are joining us today. We're together as a community. We will celebrate our creativity and share our passion of fragrance. What led up to this event was an extraordinarily challenging time. We have all spent the last 15 months redefining our lives. We have been forced to slow down. We have had to find our own way. We have had to transform our lives to decide for ourselves what's truly important and how to adjust our values. We have hopefully grounded ourselves with a new level of appreciation. We are now about to emerge more resilient than ever. And what I learned this past year, that it's far more important to realize one must live La Dolce Vita every day in everyday life. So just before this, you have viewed an excerpt of an Oprah Winfrey interview with our Fragrance Foundation creative collaborator and exceptionally talented man, Louis Schwartzberg. Please allow me to share the Fragrance Foundation's connection with Louis, why we are thrilled to welcome him officially into the community today, and have him join us for the big event. Hello, Louis, and thank you for joining us from LA today.
I love being with you, Linda, and thank you for inviting me to this great event.
How do you think scent has transformed people along? Because you've been smelling flowers for quite a while, and we've been smelling flowers in the fragrance community. Right. Or obsessed, as I said. What is that experience like for you?
Well, there's something really, I think, similar between the flowers and the filmmaking that I do. And I've noticed that when people either, you know, have a beautiful fragrance or watch my films, there's a common phrase, "Oh my God." And I wonder, what does that really mean? And I think the O makes you present. The my touches the deepest part of your soul. And God is that universal energy we all want to be connected to. And the flowers and the imagery, they do the same thing. They grab your attention. Like you said, they slow you down, you know, slow down and smell the roses, right? And pause for a moment, and to see the flower open and close and open and close, you know, it does sort of make you slow down.
I'm going to propose that we're going to find our next journey together somewhere you haven't been, and we'll be smelling the roses together.
The plan. Love it, Linda. Like I said, you had me at hello.
Thank you, Louis. It's a great thing to see you today. Thanks for your time.
Sure.
And I think we're going to be together forever.
You got it. Okay.
Okay. Enjoy LA the rest of the day.
And thank you. Thank you, everybody, to Fragrance Foundation. Really appreciate it.
And now I am very proud to introduce Jerry Vittoria, Chairman of the Fragrance Foundation and President of Fine Fragrance Worldwide at Firmenich.
Thanks, Linda. I add my very warm welcome on behalf of the entire Fragrance Foundation board. This is our second virtual awards event. While we may miss the elegance and camaraderie of our events at Lincoln Center, to say nothing of the beautiful fragrances worn by all, we learned last year that there is one huge benefit to this virtual format. Rather than just a few hundred industry experts sharing in the excitement and the buzz of these honors, we now connect with several thousand of you. And not just the industry experts and retail selling specialists, but fragrance lovers from the broader fragrance community in New York, the US, and around the world. Indeed, thanks to this format and the social media networks of our members, our fragrance influencers and fragrance lovers worldwide, together with our fantastic special guest presenters, the reach of these awards is now at numbers that we could only have dreamt of 2 years ago. These awards are a true celebration of fragrance excellence. We honor the inspiring and wonderful creations and innovations of our fragrance industry. I encourage you to share these awards with as wide an audience as possible. Indeed, inclusiveness will be the legacy of these virtual events as we move forward from the pandemic and back to physical hybrid events in the years to come. While the pandemic has hit our industry hard, our consumers' reaction and evolution of their fragrance rituals emphasizes the importance of fragrance in all our lives. Over the past 16 months, much spent in our homes, often separated from friends and family, fragrance played an important role in comforting us, reminding us of loved ones, relaxing us, and energizing us. Simply put, fragrance has played a powerful role in supporting us with all the positive emotions we needed to face the challenges before us. For so many who caught COVID, including myself, how terrible were those days when we lost our sense of smell, not being able to enjoy all the scents that combine to make our home so special. Did you know that with the Fragrance Foundation and the support of industry experts, Monell Institute has found that adding simple scent training to daily routines aids those who lost smell in recovery. Now more than ever, the benefits of fragrances are recognized by all. Romance and seduction are well and good, but there are so many other important emotions that we can activate to capture a far wider number of consumers. Indeed, the feel-good factor of fragrance is a huge opportunity for our entire industry. I am convinced that all these benefits, combined with science-based, safe, and renewable ingredients, will drive new innovations and exponential growth for all our members. A final word on the Fragrance Foundation team. I know how much work goes into these virtual events and all the inspiring events of the past year. Our small team at the Fragrance Foundation under Linda Levy's leadership has continued to show amazing resilience throughout the past year in driving an ambitious program and especially in preparing today's event. On behalf of the entire board, I want to sincerely thank Linda and her team, Sharnay, Christina, Alisar, and Ilgaz. It is now my pleasure to kick off the awards.
I am thrilled today to introduce fantastic Isabella Rossellini, actress, author, philanthropist, and model.
It is a great honor to be a presenter for the Fragrance Foundation Award. I love fragrances. I loved it since I was a little girl. I always dreamt when I was going to be grown up, I could wear a fragrance. To me, it meant that made me a woman. Fragrance also is important to me because it had to do a lot with my professional life. I represented one of the greatest perfumes, the greatest classic, Trésor. I also, when I work as an actress, I give different perfume to the character I play because perfume has such strong personality. It helps me define the person that I am portraying. I've used Trésor for 30 years. It is my second skin. It is the first thing that I do when I travel. I enter a place that is not mine. Now it's mine. The Fragrance Foundation mission is to inspire the world to discover the artistry and passion of fragrance. This mission is shared and amplified, but is beautifully written, engaging, enlightening, fragrance stories that appear in the print media this year. And the finalists are
Fragrance Editorial of the Year, print. 10 Men Magazine, Sex Education, 10 Minutes to Read About the World of Scent, Clayton Ilolahia. Elle Magazine, O Ex Machina, Jennifer Goldstein Sullivan. The New York Times, Now Germs Can Die Bathed in a Heavenly Scent, Rachel Felder. Oh, the Oprah Magazine, Sense of Wonder, Jamie Rosen. Town and Country, It Smells Good in Here, April Long. And the winner is Town and Country, It Smells Good in Here, April Long.
Hi, I'm April Long, the beauty director at Town & Country, and thank you, Fragrance Foundation, for this incredible honor. And thank you to all the perfumers who gave me so much of their time and insight when I was writing this article.
It is something we all know. Describing a fragrance with words is challenging. But the writers who brought us these digital stories in 2020 brought the scent to life, were also educating us, exciting us, making us think why and how we love fragrances. The finalists are
Fragrance Editorial of the Year, Digital. Allure, The Weird World of Olfactory Training, Beth Shapori. Allure, How COVID-19 Has Changed the Fragrance Industry, At Least for Now, Jessica Chia. Ça Fleur Bon, Scents and the Surrealist, Salvador Dali and His Love Affair with Fragrance, Marianne Butler. Harper's Bazaar, How to Find a New Signature Scent Without Ever Smelling It, Jenna Rosenstein. Town and Country, How Signature Is Your Signature Scent? Why Now Is the Perfect Time to Craft a Custom Perfume, April Long. And the winner is Town and Country, How Signature Is Your Signature Scent? Why Now Is the Perfect Time to Craft a Custom Perfume, April Long.
Hi, I'm April Long, the beauty director at Town and Country, and thank you for this incredible honor. It was so thrilling to meet Serge Lutens for this story, and it means even more that this story has been recognized. Thank you.
Our next presenter is Narciso Rodriguez, Major Fave award-winning designer.
Good evening. I am happy to be here with you tonight to celebrate fragrance, which I too hold near to my heart. Creating a fragrance was a dream of mine and one that I was very passionate about. 25 years ago, I sought to make a fragrance that was addictive, sensual, and eternally beautiful. The result was For Her. To me, fragrance says as much about the creator as it does the wearer. It is about expressing your inner self, your subconscious. It is a signature that often leaves a more lasting impression than anything you choose to wear. A unique fragrance's first and foremost quality is its ability to tell a story. It can be the ultimate fantasy. Not only are these scents as distinctive as they are democratic, they are also evocative of places, moods, and modes of self-expression. The finalists for Fragrance of the Year, Universal Prestige, inspire us to dream. The finalists are
Fragrance of the Year, Universal Prestige. Diptyque, Eau Capitale, Eau de Parfum, Givaudan, Olivier Pécheux. Jo Malone London, Vetiver and Golden Vanilla, Cologne Intense. Estée Lauder Companies, Man, Mathilde Bajoui. Maison Margiela, Replica Bubble Bath, L'Oréal, Man, Violaine Calais. Tom Ford, Black Orchid Parfum, Estée Lauder Companies, Givaudan, Yann Vasnier. And the winner is Tom Ford, Black Orchid Parfum, Estée Lauder Companies, Givaudan, Yann Vasnier.
Good afternoon. I am Nathalie Berger-Duquesne, Senior Vice President, Global Marketing, Tom Ford Beauty. Thank you to everyone who voted for Black Orchid Parfum. We are honored to receive this prestigious award. Thank you to Karen Cooey, Helen Murphy, and the talented perfumer from Givaudan, Yann Vasnier, who brought Tom Ford's vision to life. Also, a big thank you to the whole Tom Ford Beauty team. Thank you so much.
Fragrance of the Year, Universal Luxury. It can be said that every fragrance is all-encompassing, but some are especially so. Each of these exceptional luxury scents offers a unique, exquisite experience that transcends gender and makes us forget any preconceived notions about notes. The finalists are
Fragrance of the Year, Universal Luxury. Armani Privé, Lizzo T. Yulong, L'Oréal. Man, Julie Massé. By Killian, Paris, Angels Share, The Estée Lauder Companies, Givaudan, Benoist Lapuza. Byredo, Tobacco Mandarin, Robert T., Jérôme Epinette. Gucci, The Alchemist's Garden, A Midnight Stroll, Cody. Firmenich, Alberto Moreas. Maison Christian Dior, Oud Rosewood. Parfum Christian Dior, François Demachy. And the winner is
Byredo, Tobacco Mandarin, Robert Tay, Jerome Epinette.
I'm honored to accept this award and appreciate the recognition the Fragrance Foundation has given to Tobacco Mandarin. Our Night Veil's perfume extract showcases a refined perfume tradition that focuses on using the highest quality materials to offer an intense olfactory experience designed to evoke timeless emotion. And I'm glad that this tradition has not gone unnoticed. Special thank you to Jerome Epinette and the Roberti Group for helping us bring the feeling of Tobacco Mandarin to life.
Congratulations. Goodbye. Wish you all the best.
And now, everyone, the magnificent Andre Leon Talley, fashion journalist and author.
I'm so happy to be with you all this evening. I am Andre Leon Talley. I think most of you know who I am. I'm very happy to be here with my fellow colleagues, some of whom I feel are very close friends, Mark Jacobs, Isabella Rossellini, but I'm so happy to be with Miss Dolly Parton. And I would like to say, wow, Dolly Parton, you did a great thing last year when you donated all that money for the redevelopment of the vaccine. You are our heroine. I think fragrance is a very vital point of life. And I'm so happy to be here because I have been working on my own personal scent for the last 8 years with Theo Spielke of Feminish. As we know, we've come through the pandemic. It is a moment about cocooning ourselves in comfort of memory, the recall of childhood happiness, the recall of your wedding, the recall of that moment when you got a great job, the recall of that fabulous voyage to the unknown lands of Exotica, Hawaii, Thailand, Russia. The prestige fragrance is a category that is about uniqueness. It's about empowering the boldness of originality and individuality. And here the finalists are.
Fragrance of the Year, Women's Prestige. Giorgio Armani, My Way, L'Oreal, IFF, Carlos Benaim. Jo Malone London, Fig and Lotus Flower Cologne, Estee Lauder Companies, IFF, Alexis Dadier. Marc Jacobs, Perfect Eau de Parfum, Coty, IFF, Domitille Michelin Berthier. Miss Dior, Rose and Roses, Parfum Christian Dior, François Demachy. Nest New York, Sunkissed Hibiscus, Firmenich, Gabriella Chilaroux. And the winner is Giorgio Armani, My Way, L'Oreal, IFF, Carlos Benaim.
Thank you so much to the Fragrance Foundation for this award. I'm Pia Newkirk, the Vice President of Marketing at Armani Beauty. I want to first thank Mr. Armani for his unwavering commitment to focusing on sustainability and our impact on nature. Grazie mille to our global Armani partners who crafted a beautiful story that made us all dream of the connections we have been longing for during this very isolating time. My Way is the first carbon neutral fragrance focusing on sustainably sourced ingredients, refillability, and forest preservation programs with 64% less plastic and carbon emissions. Thank you to Carlos Benaim for the gorgeous floral Eau de Parfum with its uplifting citrus, vanilla, and tuberose. This juice brought to life experiences and connection that not only enrich your life, but those around with its beautiful, authentic story portrayed by the elegant Adria Aroha, embracing the motto, I am what I live. Grazie mille.
Fragrance of the Year, Women's Luxury. Hello, I'm here to present this category. I'm happy to be here this evening at this momentous, prestigious foundation awards. And this category is about being divine, feeling extraordinary, being wonderful and feeling so great about life. We need that now more than ever as we come through a very difficult year for everyone globally. And here we are celebrating something so important, so pivotal to women, scent, fragrance. The fragrance that is an indulgence of happy moments, celebratory moments, joyful moments, And we are happy to present these awards. And for the Women's Luxury Fragrance category, the finalists are
Fragrance of the Year, Women's Luxury. Armani Privé, Lizzo Rose Milano, L'Oreal, Firmenich, Daphne Bougie, and Marie Salamagne. Chanel, Coco Mademoiselle, L'Eau Privée, Olivier Polge. Gucci, The Alchemist's Garden, A Chant for the Nymph, Coty, Firmenich, Alberto Moreas. The Harmonist, Moon Glory, Givaudan, Guillaume Flavigny. Jo Malone London, Gardenia and Oud Absolu, Estee Lauder Companies, IFF, Sophie Labbé. Tom Ford, Bitter Peach, Estee Lauder Companies, IFF, Laurent Le Guernec, and Jean-Marc Chalin. And the winner is Gucci, The Alchemist's Garden, A Chant for the Nymph, Coty, Firmenich, Alberto Moreas.
Hello, I'm Jordan Saxmord, Vice President of Marketing for Gucci Beauty. Thank you to the Fragrance Foundation for this incredible honor. This beautiful fragrance was born from the magnetism of two alchemists, Gucci's incomparable creative director, Alessandro Michele, and master perfumer, Alberto Moreas. It is because of their vision and expertise that this exceptional scent came to life, which in true Gucci fashion transports us to a whole new world of magical nymphs on a warm summer night. I would also like to extend my gratitude to everyone at Gucci and Firmenich for your collaboration and partnership, the team at Coty for your passion and creativity, and our retailers for your continued support of Gucci and the Alchemist Garden Collection. Thank you.
Congratulations to all our winners. Congratulations.
We are so happy today to have Tom Brown join us as a presenter. He is my new neighbor, and he is an award-winning fashion designer. And one more thing. Last year, he was the winner of the Fragrance Foundation Indie Fragrance of the Year Award.
Good afternoon, everyone. It's nice to be here with you today. Fragrance is important to me. Fragrance is important to all of us. It reminds us of special moments in our lives, of special people in our lives. The packaging of a fragrance is equally important. And those two components coming together truly tell the story for a brand or a designer. I'm proud to present the Prestige Popular Packaging of the Year Award. Details are everything. They make the difference between what's expected and what's truly unique. The finalists in this category know that the smallest details can make the biggest impact. From cap weight to bottle shape, each of these finalists also know that these two components make for a strong impact. And the finalists are
Packaging of the Year, Prestige Popular. Carolina Herrera Bad Boy Eau de Toilette, Pouge. Diptyque Parfum de Voyage, Cerver et Company, Diptyque. Giorgio Armani My Way, L'Oreal, Giorgio Armani with Lloyd and Carré Bessette. Marc Jacobs Perfect Eau de Parfum, Coty. Marc Jacobs with Coty, Jackie Blue. Tom Ford Black Orchid Parfum, Estee Lauder Companies, Tom Ford. And the winner is Marc Jacobs Perfect Eau de Parfum, Coty. Marc Jacobs with Coty, Jackie Blue.
Hello, I'm Alexandra Mainka, Senior Director of US Luxury Marketing and Local Brand Management at Coty. Thank you to the Fragrance Foundation for this beautiful recognition. Perfect Eau de Parfum is a celebration of individuality and love. In true Marc Jacobs fashion, the packaging is a creative blend of unexpected. Elegant and classic bottle is crowned with eclectic collection of charms, each one selected by Marc himself. A tremendous thank you to Marc Jacobs, who injected his touch of irreverent style into the design, the Marc Jacobs team for their continued collaboration and partnership, the Coty team for the hard work and passion, and our retailers for their continued support. Thank you so much.
I'm now proud to present the Luxury Packaging of the Year Award. Through use of color or type, sculpture or shape, the finalists in this category invite us to experience fragrance in more ways than one. They know that the story truly begins the moment you pick up the bottle. And the finalists are
Packaging of the Year, Luxury. By Kilian Paris, Angel's Share, Estee Lauder Companies, Carré Bassette. Christian Louboutin, Louis Rouge, Pouge, Christian Louboutin, Beauty. Édition de Parfum, Frédéric Malle, 20th Anniversary Limited Edition Collection, Estee Lauder Companies, Édition de Parfum. Frédéric Malle, Patrick Lee. Tiziana Terenzi, Sea Stars Atlantide Extrait de Parfum Underwater Fragrance, The Fragrance Group, Tiziana Terenzi. Tom Ford, Rose Prick, Estee Lauder Companies, Tom Ford. And the winner is Christian Louboutin, Louis Rouge, Pouge, Christian Louboutin Beauty.
Hello everyone, my name is Jessica Fang and I'm the brand manager for Christian Louboutin Beauty here in the US. On behalf of Pouge and the Christian Louboutin Beauty team, I am incredibly honored and humbled to be accepting the Packaging of the Year Award for Louis Rouge fragrance within the Louis World Collection. First, I'd like to thank the Fragrance Foundation for their continued support and their dedication to recognizing the creativity and hard work within our industry. Next, I'd like to thank Christian Louboutin and Studio Ange, who are the masterminds behind this amazing Louis Rouge packaging. The care and creativity our teams put behind this fragrance is unparalleled, and without them, none of this would be possible. And finally, to our amazing Pouge family, including our internal teams, our field teams, and our retail partners, we thank you endlessly for your hard work and commitment to making Louis Rouge a success.
And now, the one and only Dolly Parton, a role model for all of us, an award-winning singer, songwriter, actress, humanitarian, and much, much more.
Well, I am so excited to be presenting all these wonderful things to all these wonderful people with all these wonderful smells. For the candle and home category, the holidays are not just about baking cookies, watching family movies, singing your favorite songs. It's also about spending time with family and friends. There is so much to love around the holidays, and these candle and home holiday fragrance of the year finalists made everything merry and bright. And the finalists are...
Fragrance of the Year, Candle and Home Holiday. Boy Smells, Broken Rosary, Ferminiche, Pierre Negrin, and Amy Vertuccio. Diptyque, Marvelous Beasts Holiday Collection, Givaudan, Olivier Pecheux. Nest New York, Blue Cypress and Snow, Roberté, Jérôme Epinette. Tom Ford, Lost Cherry Candle, Estee Lauder Companies, Givaudan, Louise Turner, and John Gamba. And the winner is... Nest New York, Blue Cypress and Snow, Roberté, Jérôme Epinette.
Hi, it's Laura Slatkin, founder of Nest New York. I'm so excited to receive this award for our Blue Cypress and Snow fragrance that was created by Jérôme Epinette of Roberté. I'm so grateful to my wonderful team at Nest New York and to the Fragrance Foundation and the entire fragrance community and all of the wonderful retailers that have supported us. Thank you.
In the Fragrance Hall of Fame category, what does it take to be a Hall of Famer? Well, you've got to have longevity, timelessness, and the kind of star power that enchants generation after generation. These five finalists have made their mark and have all the ingredients to be forever famous. The finalists are...
Hall of Fame. Calvin Klein, Euphoria. Coty, IFF. Dominique Ropion, Carlos Benaim, and Locke Dong. Diptyque, Dosan, Eau de Toilette. Man, Fabrice Pellegrin. Estee Lauder Pleasures, Eau de Parfum. Ferminiche, Annie Bozantian, and Alberto Moreas. Lancôme, Trésor,
L'Oreal, IFF, Sophia Grossman. Narciso Rodriguez for her Eau de Toilette, Shiseido, Givaudan, Christine Nagel, and Frances Kirk Dijon. And the winner is Lancôme Trésor, L'Oreal, IFF, Sophia Grossman.
I would like to accept this award on behalf of worldwide Lancôme fragrance team at L'Oreal. Thank you so much to Fragrant Foundation for admitting Trésor into the Honorable Hall of Fame. I'd like to particularly thank IFF that 30 years ago created the perfume with the extraordinary nose, Sophia Grossman. I have to tell you a story. I had totally fallen in love with this fragrance. And Lancôme tried different fragrances, different essence, and I said, oh, I hope they select this one. This one is the best. And finally, it was selected. I was so happy because I was going to represent as a model, as an ambassadress all over the world, and representing something that you love is much easier than something that you love. So I said, can I meet Sophia Grossman? And they arranged for a lunch. And I arrived in a restaurant in New York, and I saw a witch sitting on the table, dark. It was Sophia. I sat with her, and she told me, a few years ago, I saw a film, and the mood of the film inspired the fragrance that became Trésor, and the film was Casablanca. Casablanca. But that's the most famous film that my mom, Ingrid Bergman, did. I couldn't believe it, all the dots connected. I said, wait, Sophia, when I smelled Trésor for the first time, I felt such a warmth, such tenderness, like an embrace. It was magic, it was wonderful. And this has been my fragrances for 30 years. I want to thank, and I'm going to say it in all possible language that comes to mind. Merci, grazie, salamapo, tac tac, arigato, tie tie, to our DMI, to the retailers, to the press, for their constant support of Trésor, and to all the clients and people like me that wear it. Thank you.
Now is the exciting moment in our awards program to induct Philippe Bennesson, Chairman and CEO of Interparfums, to the Fragrance Foundation Hall of Fame. First, we will share a short film with you which illustrates what has led up to this momentous occasion.
Here is the story of a man who luckily missed out on his vocation as a rock star. Trader. Really? Agribusiness industrial. Come on. This man is Philippe Bennesson, and hopefully he decides to create perfumes.
Perfume is a living thing. You need to feel the lyricism and the intellectual behind the brand. Even it's very philosophical very often. And it is super important for us to follow the brand in order to reinterpret it in terms of fragrances.
We created Interparfums in 1983. Jean Madar and myself have been partners since day one and are still marvelous partners together. Jean being the chief officer of the US operation. I'm the chief officer for the French and international operation outside of France.
Our brand portfolio is very large. For America, we have always been very strong with four brands that are Montblanc and Jimmy Choo when we started, Coach, and more recently, Kate Spade.
After that, you have all the network where we distribute the fragrances, and the network is at a high level, either department store or perfumeries, as you know, and all this network helps tremendously to convey this luxury image on our fragrances.
The world of luxury is created through a multitude of details that are important one after the other.
such as the shape of the glass, its weight, and its quality. It's about the juice that must also transcribe olfaction, certainly, but we must also smell that the raw materials are natural or at a high quality, so that there is an impression of luxury from the first spray. I'm very optimistic for the company and the fact that the company can achieve even more in the future.
As you can see, Philippe is well known for his entrepreneurial spirit, contagious enthusiasm, and dedication to his team. Characteristics that have enabled him to lead Inter Parfums and his team of over 400 global employees to many accomplishments. Next up, Nicolas Merzianz, Divisional CEO of Scent at IFF, who has known Philippe over 30 years, will share much about Philippe because he is the perfect friend and colleague to share more than you learned in the video of why Philippe is so very deserving of this honor.
Good afternoon, Linda, and good afternoon to everyone. I have the true delight and privilege to introduce to you my longtime friend, now for over 30 years, Philippe Benasson. All of us are very familiar with his many great achievements. Montblanc, Jimmy Choo, Van Cleef, Coach, Rochas, and soon to be launched, Moncler. Just hearing these iconic brands evoke his success and legacy in the world of perfume and fashion. And while I'm very grateful to say a few words about Philippe, I can only imagine how all of this praising must make him feel a bit awkward. For he is, in every sense of the word, a truly humble and gifted creator and businessman. A discreet gentleman who never seeks the limelight and is utterly selfless, putting first always his team, his brands, his partners, and his perfumers. Since 1983, when he and Jean Madar started Inter Parfums in a ground floor apartment near Place Vendôme in Paris, to now running global operations today. His passion, instinct, authenticity, and generosity of spirit have been constant. The life and the love he breathes into the development of each and every fragrance is second to none. And still to this day, is deeply involved in the olfactive development process at every step, which for someone at his level of responsibility is truly remarkable. Put simply, Inter Parfums success and prestige is a reflection of who Philippe is and a great testament to his character. His generosity and compassion extend outside his company, including through his philanthropy and support for Ellie's Care, an NGO that helps religious minorities in conflict zones. I would, of course, be remiss if I did not mention that in addition to being a passionate art collector, Philippe is a true rock star, as you saw in the video, a real Jimi Hendrix, who every year at his company holiday party picks up one of his electric guitars to perform for his team. And don't forget about his unmistakable sense of humor, his sense of style with his signature YSL cowboy boots, black jeans, and pristine white shirts. He's a very loyal friend, and thus he inspires loyalty like no one else. Just ask any of his lifetime friends or colleagues at Inter Parfums who will attest that once you meet Philippe, you are completely attached to him and want to be by his side forever and ever. So without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, I'm deeply honored to present this year's distinguished recipient of the Hall of Fame Award, Mr. Philippe Benasson.
Hall of Fame. Philippe Benasson, President and CEO, Inter Parfums.
Thank you, Nicolas, for your words. Thank you to all of you for welcoming me into this Hall of Fame. Reading my name close to Tom Ford and Anne Gottlieb, it is quite unexpected for the French entrepreneur I am. As you could see in the video, I could have embraced many other careers. At least tonight, I think I made the right choice. Better working with Jimmy Choo than trying to be Jimi Hendrix. Listening to the ceremony has been music to my ears. If Americans remain the kings of rock and roll, I believe you quite appreciate our French flair. Here, I could give you dozens of examples, but you already know them all. And I promised not to quote any brand. I prefer to stick to my band. So back to Inter Parfum. Why? Because in business as in music, in luxury as in art, it's all about the human. Let me tell you three short stories. Here are three remarkable individuals that made me who I am today. First story is Jean Madar. You all know him in the US. He's my friend from business school. We launched our perfume startup there. Year after year, from outsiders, we became insiders. We turned fate into fame. Inter Parfum will turn 40 next year. Jean, you are my longest love story, I guess. Second story is also close to my heart, and my heart is broken. Fashion's kindest man, as New York Times wrote, passed away a few weeks ago. But Albert Elba's spirit is still with us. We miss you, Albert. Third and last story is about a detail-oriented person. And as you all know, the devil is in the details, and I'm sure the devil wears Moncler. Remo Ruffini is the most inspiring fashion partner I recently met. You need a career to enter the Hall of Fame. You also need a future to still shine with the stars. Remo is a character that makes sure you stay on top. Can't wait to reveal our upcoming amazing surprise with Moncler. To conclude, beyond Jean, Albert and Remo, I want to bring with me in this Hall of Fame 200 women. What a French lover you may think, but no joke here. These 200 women are the women of Inter Parfum. They represent 70% of our talents. They are key to our success. Talking about success, let me finish with the quote from my friend Albert. Success is like a perfume. You can smell it, but never drink it. It was a great pleasure to be with you tonight. Many thanks again.
And now, our next presenter, Alicia Keys, Grammy award-winning singer, songwriter, producer, author, activist, and entrepreneur and co-creator of Keys Soul Care. This girl is on fire.
Good afternoon, beautiful people. I'm so excited to be here with you today and being able to present these amazing awards. If you don't know, I am obsessed with fragrance. I have candles in like every corner of my house. I love it to just assault my senses. It feels so good because scent is, it's a connection. It's such a deep, beautiful way to connect with each other and memories and our experiences and those special things that we'll never forget. For me and for all of us today, I'm pretty sure our fragrances and the way that we scent our lives is so personal and it's so special and we love it, just like these next nominees. Let's check them out. To achieve success in the indie fragrance, especially in a challenging year that was 2020, you need to be inventive and smart and sensational. These finalists were all that and more. The finalists are
Indie Fragrance of the Year: Arquiste Misfit, Huber Parfum, Givaudan, Rodrigo Flores Roux, DS and Durga, Jasmine Yucatan, David Maltz, Floral Street, Arizona Bloom, Eau de Parfum, Robert A., Jérôme Epinette, Chalini Parfum, Iris Lumière, Simrise, Maurice Roussel, St. Rose Vigilante, Givaudan, Linda Song. And the winner is Arquiste, Misfit, Huber Parfum, Givaudan, Rodrigo Flores Roux.
Hello, I'm Carlos Huber. I'm creator and founder of Arquiste Parfumeur. I am thrilled, honored, and privileged that Misfit has received the honor of Indie Fragrance of the Year by the Fragrance Foundation. I'd like to thank Linda Levy and all her friends behind the Fragrance Foundation for this. And of course, Givaudan, Emily Bond, and last but certainly not least, Rodrigo Flores Roux, my long-standing collaborator and my perfumer, and the genius behind the scent. Thank you.
Congratulations to all the winners. You're amazing. So much love.
Fragrance of the Year Popular. Sometimes you smell a scent and you know this will definitely hook the lucky person you choose to gift it to. The finalists for Fragrance of the Year Popular all had a hook so irresistible we simply couldn't help but choose them. The finalists are
Fragrance of the Year Popular. Ariana Grande, REM, Lux Brands, Firmenich, Alexis Grugion. David's Perfume by David Dobrik. David's Perfume No. 1, Amber and Cashmere. Flower Shop Perfumes Company, IFF, Celine Barrel. KKW Fragrance, KKW X Chris, Givaudan, Nicole Mancini. Philosophy, Amazing Grace Bergamot. Cody, Mon, Cecile Hua. The Fluid Project, Humanity, Scent Beauty, Firmenich, Gilles Clavien. And the winner is Ariana Grande, REM, Lux Brands, Firmenich, Alexis Grugion.
Hello, everyone. It is my honor to accept this award on behalf of Ariana Grande and Lux Brands. The narrative and creative inspiration behind REM was developed with the hope of bringing a feeling of nostalgia and escapism to consumers during what was an unprecedented time globally. The animated campaign featured Ari as a superhero, spreading positivity with her actions and, of course, her fragrance. The brand truly resonated around the world. A warm thank you to Ari as a creative visionary, my exceptional marketing and sales team led by Patty Tong, Natalie Streigold, and Nancy Windegrad, the endless support of our owner, Tony Bajaj, and of course, our wonderful retail partner, Ulta Beauty. Thank you so much.
Our next presenter is Marc Jacobs, the award-winning fashion designer who was just surprised as a Fragrance Foundation winner today.
I am pleased to be presenting the awards for Fragrance of the Year, Men's Luxury, and Fragrance of the Year, Men's Prestige at the Fragrance Foundation Awards. The nominees in these categories represent some of the best new fragrances of the past year, and each deserve recognition for outstanding craftsmanship, innovation, and creativity. For me, fragrance has always played such an important role in my life as part of my personal expression and daily rituals. Today, I am honored to be celebrating achievements in fragrance with you and congratulate all the nominees in every category. The finalists are
Fragrance of the Year, Men's Prestige. Carolina Herrera, Bad Boy, Eau de Toilette, Pouge, Givaudan, Quentin Biche, and Louise Turner. Dior Homme, Eau de Toilette, Parfum Christian Dior, François Demachy. Dolce & Gabbana, K by Dolce & Gabbana, Eau de Parfum. Shiseido, Firmenich, Daphne Bougie, and Nathalie Lorson. Giorgio Armani, Acqua di Gio Profondo. L'Oreal, Firmenich, Alberto Moreas. Jo Malone, London, Cypress and Grapevine, Cologne Intense. Estee Lauder Companies, IFF, Sophie Labbé. And the winner is Dior Homme Eau de Toilette, Parfum Christian Dior, François Demachy.
I'm Tim Halley, Fragrance Marketing Director at Parfum Christian Dior. It's such an honor to accept this award on behalf of our team. First, I want to thank the incredible organization that is the Fragrance Foundation for the recognition and celebration of this amazing launch. To our entire team who brought the Dior Homme launch to life, reviving and continuing to push the boundaries on this incredible brand. A special thank you to our master perfumer, François Demachy, who reinterpreted the Dior Homme juice in such a modern and innovative way. And finally, to our amazing retail partners and their continued support. It wouldn't be possible without you. Thank you.
And the finalists for Fragrance of the Year Men's Luxury are Emanogildo Zegna, Essence Roman Wood, Eau de Parfum, Estee Lauder Companies, Firmenich, Dora Bagriche, The Harmonist, Sunforce, Givaudan, Guillaume Flavigny,
Parfum de Marly, Pegasus Exclusif, Firmenich, Hamid Meradi Kashani. And the winner is Emergildo Zenia, Essence Roman Wood, Eau de Parfum, Estee Lauder Companies, Firmenich, Dora Bagrish.
Hello, I am Patrice Belliard, Global Brand President at the Estee Lauder Companies. On behalf of ADF, I would like to thank a lot for this amazing award. We all know that it starts with an incredible juice, so thank you to Dora Bagrish at Firmenich for having created this amazing fragrance made of bergamot, cypress, Roman pine, and cedar wood based with amber notes. Thank you as well to our amazing retail partners for their support and to my team who have been working with dedication, passion, and creativity. Thank you as well for the recognition, Linda, and to the entire Fragrance Foundation.
For all of us in the fragrance community, the Lifetime Achievement Perfumer Award is the culmination of an extraordinary perfumer's career based on decades of accomplishments, as well as a milestone marking more achievements to follow. So it gives me great pleasure to announce on behalf of the Fragrance Foundation, our 2021 Lifetime Achievement Perfumer is Khalise Becker. First, we will share a film where those who have worked, admired, and loved Khalise over the years will tell their story.
My ideas, they can come from everywhere. And sometimes the most peculiar encounters can give me the most crazy ideas. It happened to me once to have a butter infused with tonka beans. I was drinking a Saint-Nicolas de Bourgueil. Together appeared suddenly a vanilla bean.
What Khalise inspires me in the first place is obviously the many successes, the many long-standing fine fragrances that she has created.
Khalise is an iconic perfumer who's created many long-standing fragrances, such as Dior J'adore, Tommy Girl, Beyond Paradise, and many of Kilian fragrances. An amazing career and ongoing.
I remember one night I was in Istanbul and I was having what I loved, which is Turkish coffee. And I said to Khalise, I would love to do a cardamom coffee for scent. A week later, I had an accord. A year later, it became my perfume, Intoxicated.
We began our work together on Tommy Girl, which, as many of you may know, was a global success and really marked a turning point in her extraordinary career.
Working together on J'adore was one of the great achievements for both of us, but also one of the great developmental projects. And she has her heart in everything that she does.
What makes Khalise so special as a perfumer, the first has been the significance of many of her creations in the market. The second is the way that she has championed perfumers and perfumery as the director of the perfumery school at Givaudan.
Khalise came in not just with ideas about honoring the traditional methods by which we learn, but also being future thinking and bringing changes where they made sense.
There's always enough joy, there's always enough beauty, there's always enough time. She makes you feel special, she gives you the time, but she also shares her ideas. She never looks back, she always looks forward.
You learn a lot when you're with her, as a friend, as a perfumer, as a collaborator, as a professional. But at the same time, listening is one of her biggest things.
Khalise has taken over many of the digital projects that we have to reinvent and to support the work of perfumers with digital tool, artificial intelligence, Carto.
As a perfumer, my favorite part of the journey of creation is the tension when you create something in your head, you write it down, and you wait until it comes back from the lab. I really wanted to shrink this time and to concentrate it so you can just be in the joy of creating. And also, I wanted to be able to grab all the ingredients and to have them at the tip of my fingers. And that's how I created Carto.
Another way where Kelly's entrepreneurship and vision is also demonstrated is in the role that she has taken with the SIPC.
Being the president of the SIPC is not a small task because you have to bring all together the perfumers from all around the world. But I'm quite proud of the fact that we were able to put together a charter that first defines our work and will help us to be recognized as authors, and that the work of perfumers is a work of the mind. For the last 36 years, I've learned so much, and I keep learning. And I think I'm as curious as the first day, but there is something that I've really learned, is that a fragrance created with joy will bring a lot of joy.
Now I am so happy to introduce Gilles Andrier, the Chief Executive Officer at Givaudan, who has the opportunity to share more with you about Kelis as a creator, leader, and teacher.
So we are very moved, very honored to see Kelis being recognized, rewarded with this Fragrance Foundation Award. I'd like to thank Linda Levy. I'd like to thank the members of the Fragrance Foundation, the members of the board, for this recognition today.
Lifetime Achievement Perfumer. Kelis Becker, Vice President Perfumer and Director of the Givaudan Perfumery School.
I am extremely pleased and also humbled by this amazing Lifetime Achievement Award that I would have not even dreamed of having. So a huge, huge thank you to the board of the Fragrance Foundation and very most specially to Linda. Thank you, Linda.
And now to present is Christian Siriano, award-winning fashion designer whose dresses almost stole the show this award season.
Hi, everyone. I'm Christian Siriano, and I am so excited to be here this year presenting at the Fragrance Foundation Awards. I have had a fragrance for a long time, and probably something that's my favorite part of my brand's DNA, something that we've really worked on and developed, like many of the other nominees tonight. And I think what's so beautiful about fragrance is it really can change a person's perception and mood every day when they get up and get dressed and approach life. And I think that that's what's really beautiful about fragrance. So I am glad that we are celebrating that tonight. I'm here to present Media Campaign of the Year Women's. Like a fashion show, a media campaign sets the stage and creates an atmosphere. It makes you fall in love even before you've ever caught your first whiff. These women's fragrance campaigns brought beauty and glamour to the world in a year that we needed to dream more than ever. And the finalists are...
Media Campaign of the Year, Women's. Donna Karan, Cashmere Mist, Estee Lauder Companies. Jo Malone London, Lavender Land, Estee Lauder Companies. Marc Jacobs, Perfect, Coty. Mikimoto, Float on Reality. Valentino, Voce Viva, L'Oreal. And the winner is... Marc Jacobs, Perfect, Coty.
Hello, I'm Fred Arbel, Senior VP of US Marketing Luxury at Coty. Thank you to the Fragrance Foundation for this incredible honor. The media campaign for Perfect is an inclusive illustration of self-love and authenticity, featuring a diverse cast of 42 talents, handpicked through an open social media casting call. With a multitude of personalities, body shapes, sexual orientations, and more, each cast member reveals their own unique way of being perfect. A huge thank you to the Marc Jacobs team for your partnership and your creativity, Jurgen Taylor and Katie Grant for their creative direction, our amazing cast for bringing this perfect concept to life, and last but not least, the Coty team for your passion and your dedication. Thank you.
Now for Media Campaign of the Year, Men's. bold, adventurous, sensitive, suave, a little cheeky. A successful men's fragrance campaign inspires us to be everything a man can be. And these finalists made us feel like they could take on the world and smell amazing doing it. So the finalists are...
Media Campaign of the Year, Men's. Calvin Klein, CK Everyone, Coty. Dior Homme, Eau de Toilette, Parfum Christian Dior. Yves Saint Laurent, Y, L'Eau de Parfum, L'Oreal. And the winner is... Calvin Klein, CK Everyone, Coty.
Hi, I'm Alexandra Mainka, Senior Director of US Luxury Marketing and Local Brand Management at Coty. Thank you to the Fragrance Foundation for this recognition. The CK Everyone campaign is a tribute to individuality and the freedom of self-expression. In a bold collaboration between fashion and fragrance, the cast of CK Everyone celebrates the multiplicity of one and redefining boundaries to proclaim, I am one, I am many, I love every one of me. A tremendous thank you to the Calvin Klein team for their creativity and partnership. Our film director, Sam De Jong, and photographer, Glenn Latchford. All our campaign talents for portraying and embodying the CK Everyone values. Our retailers for their support. Alberto Morillas and the team at Firmenich. The Coty teams for their hard work and dedication.
I want to say congratulations to all the winners for putting in so much hard work in an unbelievable year. I know that everyone works so hard, and I'm so excited to see all of the beauty that you all have created this year, and I hope next year is just as fabulous. Congratulations.
Next up are two more categories that recognize creativity in ways that are distinguished from many other awards today. Perfume Extraordinaire is the one category where fragrances are submitted anonymously in agnostic bottles and judged by perfumers who are not nominated in this category. For this, an innovative product of the year, I am thrilled to welcome back Isabella Rossellini to present.
Every perfume is a work of art, a story that we wear on our skin. And some fragrances create exceptionally daring, creative narratives. Effective narrative, of course. Through the imagination of the perfumer, we can be taken somewhere that feels totally new. And these five finalists for the Perfume Extraordinaire prove that there are no limits to what can be expressed through a scent. The finalists are...
Perfume Extraordinaire. Galavant, Bukhara, Mon, Ralph Schweiger. Garden of Grace, Cosmo International Fragrances, Flori Tanquerel. Gucci, The Alchemist's Garden, Hortus Sanitatis, Firmenich, Alberto Moreas. Memo, Paris, Retba, Simrise, Philippe Paparella Paris. Scents of Wood, Plum in Cognac, IFF, Pascal Gorin. And the winner is... Scents of Wood, Plum in Cognac, IFF, Pascal Gorin.
Good afternoon. My name is Pascal Gorin. I'm a vice president, senior perfumer at International Flavors and Fragrances, and I created Plum in Cognac for Scents of Wood. First, I want to congratulate my fellow perfumers nominated tonight. Flori, Alberto, Philippe and Ralph, I am sincerely honored to have been nominated with you. Thank you, Linda and the Fragrance Foundation team for your work. Thank you to my IFF family, to our R&D department, our natural division, Laboratoire Monique Rémy, for their constant quest to provide perfumers with innovative molecules and the most beautiful natural extracts available on this planet. Annie, Pamela, Julia, and Frederick, thanks for your help and support. It's a huge honor to receive the 2021 Perfume Extraordinaire Award for this creation only 9 months after Sense of Wood launched its very first fragrance. Brands are always a reflection of their creators. Fabrice Croiset, your love for nature and compromising stand for creativity and luxury, and your constant quest for innovation is reflected in each bottle of Sense of Wood. Working on Plumbing Cognac has been a beautiful journey, and the consumer reaction the most beautiful reward I could have wished for. Thank you, Fabrice, for sharing your vision and giving me the opportunity to tell your story. A big portion of this award is yours, brother. I hope this unique fragrance will bring you as much pleasure to wear as it did for us to create. Thank you.
It is said that necessity is the mother of invention, right? And the past year has offered a great opportunity, and we have seen the development of countless visionary, inventive new ways to scent our homes, our cars, ourselves, our PPE. This innovative fragrance product showed us that we do think outside the box. The box, rather the bottle. The finalists are
Fragrance Innovative Product of the Year, Diptyque Electric Wall Diffuser, Bayes, Fragonard, Cervere & Company, Fueguilla 1833 Aguas for Skin and Textile, Julian Bedell, Jo Malone London Car Diffuser, Wood Sage and Sea Salt, Estee Lauder Companies, Mann, Jo Malone London Global Creative Team, Loban Perfumes Scent Infused Face Mask, Dried French Lavender, Stacey Bresnahan, The Fluid Project Integrity, Scent Beauty, Firmenich, Scent Beauty R&D. And the winner is Diptyque Electric Wall Diffuser, Bayes, Fragonard, Cervere & Company.
Great pleasure to accept this award. Many thanks to the Fragrance Foundation for this honor in the innovation category. At Diptyque, the art of perfume and the art of living have always intertwined and reinforced each other. The Wall Diffuser, compact and practical, is our response to liberty, simplicity, and a nomadic approach. The ability to scent wherever you are in a single gesture. The diffusers borrow materials from interior decoration and design to create a sensory object, while echoing the design of Diptyque's graphic universe. Thank you to Cervere and Co. for their design leadership and creativity.
Congratulations to the winner.
And now for our next presenter is Kylie Minogue, singer, songwriter, and actress. I can't get her out of my head.
Hi, I'm Kylie Minogue, and as a bona fide fragrance lover, maniac, I'm really excited to present the next categories for the Fragrance Foundation Awards. Consumer's Choice, Candle, and Home Collection of the Year. The scents you live with are perhaps the most important of all. They surround you, infusing your space with mood-altering magic. These were the fragrances that consumers loved most for their power to say, welcome home. The finalists are
Consumer Choice, Candle, and Home Collection. Boy Smells, Slow Burn by Boy Smells ex Casey Musgraves, Robert Tay, Jerome Epinette. Jo Malone London, Pastel Macaroons Townhouse Candle. Estee Lauder Companies, CPL Aromas, Christian Provenzano. Keys Soul Care, Sage and Oat Milk Candle. Takasago, Catherine Selig. Nest New York, Amalfi Lemon and Mint, Rubber Tay, Jerome Epinette. And the winner is Boy Smells, Slow Burn by Boy Smells ex Casey Musgraves, Rubber Tay, Jerome Epinette.
Thank you so much to all of the consumers who voted in this category. When Casey Musgraves DM'd us to create a candle with her, we really didn't know where that road would lead us or how successful it would be. but it turned out to be the perfect partnership. And we're so incredibly thankful to our creative partners at Roberté. Jerome just made the most beautiful and perfect scent to encapsulate the words of Casey's song. And we've just been surprised time after time at how well it's been received by the public and the people who engage in our brand. So we're just so grateful. And also a huge thank you to Linda and the team at TFF welcoming us with open arms, this being our first years as members. So thank you. This is just a huge honor for us.
Consumers' choice, men's. Men certainly have no shortage of scents to choose from. So to make the final selection for consumers' choice means that these fragrances hit all of the right notes. The finalists are
Consumer Choice, Men's Fragrance of the Year. Calvin Klein, CK Everyone. Coty, Firmenich, Alberto Moreas. Dolce & Gabbana, K by Dolce & Gabbana Eau de Parfum. Shiseido, Firmenich. Daphne Bougie and Nathalie Lorson. Paco Rabanne, 1 Million Parfum. Pouge, Givaudan, Quentin Biche. Parfum de Marly, Pegasus Exclusif, Firmenich. Hamid Meradi Kashani. Tumi, Awaken 8 o'clock GMT, Eau de Parfum, The Fragrance Group, Takasago, Catherine Selig. And the winner is Calvin Klein, CK Everyone, Coty, Firmenich, Alberto Moreas.
Hi, I'm Fred Aubert, Senior VP of US Marketing Luxury at Coty. Thank you to the Fragrance Foundation for this amazing recognition. CK Everyone, Calvin Klein's first clean, gender-free, and environmentally conscious fragrance, is a tribute to individuality and the freedom of self-expression. Thank you first and foremost to our consumers for making this award a reality. We would also like to thank Calvin Klein, of course, for the creativity and partnership, Alberto Morillas and the whole team at Firmenich, our campaign talent, Elliot Sumner, Cara Taylor, Evan Mock, MLMA, Parker Van Noord, and Pretty the Up for portraying the CK Everyone values, our retailers for their support, our influencer partners, and of course, the Coty team for the ongoing passion and dedication. Thank you.
Consumer's choice, women's popular. Sometimes you smell a perfume and you can't get it out of your head. These are the unforgettable scents that had women most smitten this year. The finalists are
Consumer Choice, Women's Popular Fragrance of the Year. Christian Siriano, Eau La Rouge, Eau de Parfum, The Fragrance Group, Simrise, Christelle Laprade. Philosophy, Amazing Grace Bergamot, Coty, Man, Cecile Hua. Victoria's Secret, Bombshell Passion, Givaudan, Linda Song and Adriana Medina. And the winner is Victoria's Secret Bombshell Passion, Givaudan, Linda Song, and Adriana Medina.
Hello, everyone. I'm Greg Yunus, and I'm the CEO of Victoria's Secret Beauty. I'm excited to be here virtually celebrating with you all tonight. First, I'd like to thank Linda Levy and the entire Fragrance Foundation for nominating Bombshell Passion as a finalist in the Consumer Choice category. I'd also like to thank our partners at Givaudan, Linda Song and Adriana Medina, for helping us bring this bold fragrance to life. And finally, thank you to the entire team at Victoria's Secret Beauty and to all of our customers and fans who voted to make Bombshell Passion the Consumer Choice winner. It's an honor to accept this award. Thank you again.
Consumer's Choice, Women's Prestige. From the glamorous shapes of their bottles to the irresistible and irrepressible fragrances within, the finalists in Women's Prestige Consumer's Choice have some serious sex appeal. The finalists are
Consumer Choice Women's Prestige Fragrance of the Year. Carolina Herrera, Good Girl Supreme, Eau de Parfum. Pouge, Givaudan, Quentin Biche and Louise Turner. Kayali Deja Vu, White Flower 57. Huda Beauty, Firmenich, Gabriella Chilaru. Marc Jacobs Perfect, Eau de Parfum, Cody, IFF, Domitille Michel Lambertier. And the winner is Marc Jacobs Perfect, Eau de Parfum, Cody, IFF, Domitille Michel Lambertier.
Hi, I'm Fred Abel, Senior VP of US Marketing Luxury at Coty. Thank you for this amazing recognition. Perfect is inspired by Marc Jacobs' mantra, I am perfect as I am, which is symbolized by a tattoo of the word on his wrist. This fragrance is a celebration of individuality and self-love. And we thank our passionate consumers for demonstrating that this message resonated by casting their votes for this coveted award. We would also like to thank the Marc Jacobs team for their ongoing partnership and collaboration, perfumer Domitille Michel Lambertier, and the team at IFF for creating this addictive juice. The Coty team are influencer partners in helping us tell the perfect as I am story, and our retailers for their support. Thank you.
Congratulations to all the winners today. And thank you to our fabulous sponsors. We could not have done this without you. We are so looking forward to seeing you in the fall. And on behalf of the Fragrance Foundation, please accept our gratitude for all your creativity and passion for fragrance.
Congratulations to the finalists and winners. Thank you for joining us today at the Fragrance Foundation 2021 Awards. Congratulations to the finalists and winners. Thank you for joining us today at the Fragrance Foundation 2021 Awards.